Darren, has there been a bigger signing in BBL history today?
There's plenty of good players that have played internationally, but it's probably the biggest for a while, isn't it? So we're really excited. We're humbled he chose Brisbane Heat to come and play, and I think it's great for the game itself. And BBL fans will just be exciting.
I know he's not his absolute best, but he's still one of the world's best player. Is he going to dominate this competition?
Oh, I just want him to come and enjoy it, really, to be perfectly honest. And I think if he does that, he'll play well. I saw him play in England this year in the Vitality Blast, and he played really well. So no qualms about his ability. We really want him to impart some of his knowledge on our younger kids more so than anything else. So for him, come and enjoy it with his family, and hopefully he stays on for years to come.
Mm. What got the deal over the line then, in the end, Darren? Because obviously it looked like he was going to go to the Sixers at one stage.
No, we were just lucky enough that we had a good conversation with him and his management. And Baz McCullum was fantastic as well, pushing the Brisbane Heat. He loves the climate. It's very much like, as he said, Pretoria as such. So, you know, sun and surf, and a good place to entertain yourself with your family and play some cricket. So, you know, we after it sort of fell over a little bit, we kept in contact with him. And end of the day, we were really humbled that he actually chose to come back and play.
What's he doing at the start of
the tournament? Well, no, he's never had Christmas or New Year's at home with his family. So we're really supportive of that, obviously. We want him to play as many games as he can. But also understand that Christmas and, you know, New Year's a pretty special time with your family when you've played so much international cricket, haven't been home. So get him through that, and then out he comes.
So do you know sort of an idea of what fixture or what time?
It'll be roughly early January, so we're just working through those final details. But, you know, we've got him from then right through to the end, hopefully in the finals as well if we play well enough. And then from then on, hopefully he keeps coming back.
And from a competition standpoint, I mean, to have such a big name, it's really what the tournament needs, especially when the international Aussie guys are overseas.
Yeah, that's right. But also, you know, you might have a few more Aussies playing at the back end of the tournament, so it's going to be a great tournament. Shortened, new finals format, so fingers crossed, Brisbane Heat can play well, and, you know, he can get a few runs and entertain the crowd along the way, and we make the finals.
You're saying commentary, Jan, 6-8. You've got a game on the 6th.
Yeah,
we, on the night,
yeah, so it just depends which way we go there. Yeah, it depends. Get him through New Year's and then get him recovered and then let him come and play.
Gives you a lot of flexibility and options with your top order, doesn't it?
Well, it does, yeah. And obviously that's what you want when you've got a class player like AB de Villiers. Where you bat him, I mean, I'm sure we'll have that discussion, and Chris Lynn, the captain, make some decisions, how we're going, where we're placed in the competition. But, you know, him coming along is just going to be great for everyone.
And you'll be looking to use him tactically as well?
Well, it's a great experience for Chris Lynn. You know, they obviously played against each other in the IPL. I know Chris Lynn's over the moon and excited by it. But, you know, just for AB to impart his knowledge with the younger guys and leadership skills he's had with South Africa. So, for us, it's a win-win.
Does it pave the way a little bit for big-name internationals? Probably seen firsthand that probably hasn't been there the last few years.
Yeah, we hope so. We hope more want to come back and play. We're just lucky enough that, you know, AB's decided to come and play for the Heat. We obviously kept the two young Afghan spinners, so that's exciting. Majeeb comes back. So, you know, we hope we get more bigger names all the time, but you want quality as well, and that's what you're getting.
Do you have an opinion on a marquee fund or an ability to help attract big names?
Oh, you know, that's for the big boys, so I'll leave that with them to decide. They'll just tell us how much we got and how much we've got to spend.
Still the second best.
I think so, yeah. From what I've seen around the world, the England one's up there as well. You know, IPL's obviously the biggest one that everyone goes and plays for that 6-7 week period. But the BBL is a fantastic comp. But now we've shortened it makes it more attractive.
In terms of your hopes, obviously every team's trying to win the championship, but you're probably favourites now. I mean, how does that tag going to stick with you guys?
There's plenty of other good teams out there. Favouritism is just how you start. You've got to start well, as you know, and you've got to be playing the right cricket at the right end of the tournament. So, look, that's too far ahead, your favourites or anything like that.
Just one on Khawaja. You've seen him bat, obviously, the last three days. Should he head back to number three on Brisbane?
His record's very good in Australia. If you look at his record in Australia on its own, it's outstanding. And you know, he had to come back and make runs, and he's done that in his first two games in the Marsh Cup, made very good hundreds for Queensland. So, again, it'll get down to Shield performance, I suppose. But if you look at, you know, horses of courses in Australia, he's been very good.
Sorry, just on AB, have you noticed any change in the discussions? Have you noticed any changes between, say, when you saw him in South Africa 18 months ago now and how he is now? Like, what's kind of motivating him?
He wants to play in the best competitions. He still wants to play the best cricket he can, and he loves the game. He's a cricket nuffy, which is great. So he's going to be just fantastic for our young guys, and he loves playing the game. You see it, and he's just passionate. So we're really, you know, it's a great signing for us.
And he's kind of being away from international cricket, helped him a little bit.
Oh, he's really playing the 2020 circuit, isn't he, at the moment? So, in terms of skill-wise, he's got all the shots and all the tricks, and just hopefully he plays a few of them.
Just one last one, sorry, on Osman again. Would you keep him at three, or would you perhaps go with Marnus now? Is it time to...
Again, that depends on what JL and the selectors want, I suppose. They'll work their best six out and then work out the order from there. You would think, I think Warner will probably stay. You know, his record in Australia is very good. If they play Usman, does he stay at three or does he open? Marnus bat three, Smith bat four. There's a couple of opportunities there for players to start well in the Shield.
Yeah. Great, I appreciate it.
Thanks,
guys.
Really appreciate it. Thank you, Darren.
Thank you, guys.
A couple of quick radio, so obviously I get a couple on.